Well, good evening and welcome back to Monster Movie Night here at Gargoyle Manor, the Monster Museum. I am your internet horror host and creepy old curator, Bobby Gammonster, along with my pal and co-host, Boris the Buzzard. We thank you, one and all, for entering our abode, our museum of artifacts, of horror, monstrosities, and much, much more. Tonight's feature is a wonderful film called White Pongo. It's about a white ape, gorilla, in fact, that's being hunted by unscrupulous men through the jungles. And just because it's different, and it's rare, and it's, what did they say, half human? Well, we won't hold that against it, will we now? Tonight's feature is in honor, or in lieu, of a tragedy that happened this past week at a zoo. A gorilla was killed. Some people think that it was a travesty. Some people think that it was meant to be. There was a child involved. You know the story. I'm not going to rehash it, but for that poor gorilla that lost its life, and for all the many gorillas out there that are losing their battle with becoming extinct, we're showing this film in hopes that people will rally around and help save our wild gorillas, which are very few. And in fact, we'll bring out some exhibits tonight that show that exactly that. Let's start with this one here. Everyone knows this fellow here, King Kong, the most famous gorilla of all. Let me get this a little closer to you. And yes, that's better. Anyway, this was a nice box set that we have here at the museum. And, of course, we know the story of King Kong very well. He lost his life as well due to facts that people didn't quite understand him. No, they brought him to be something of an oddity, to be shown. Brought him from his homeland where he was safe and doing well. And, well, we know the story. Well, this is kind of like that story that happened in the news. Right, Boris? Exactly. So, let us go to White Pongo.
South of the equator in West Africa are vast areas of dense forests and swamplands as yet unexplored by white man. A virgin territory penetrated only by the great Congo River and its tributaries. Here in this wild, steaming portion of the dark continent is the home of the Ponga, native name for the gorilla. It was here on the fringe of gorilla territory, in a nameless native village inhabited by a tribe of fierce Negritos, an incident occurred which was destined to startle the civilized world.
Escape, and in return for my aid, you shall shall bring back to civilization the precious diary of Dr. Theodore.
I give you my word of honor.
You must succeed. For if you don't, the most astounding anthropological discovery of the ages will be lost to the world, and I will have lived in vain.
You somehow don't worry. But why don't you escape with me? The glory of such a discovery should go to you.
10 years ago, I might have attempted it. But now it's too late. You are still young enough to have a fighting chance. Now, follow my instructions, my friend, and good luck to you.
Not. He's just too weak to fight jungle fever. I don't know how he managed to travel as far as he did.
Do you think you can keep him alive till Sir Harry arrives? I expect him any day.
I don't know, Van. I'm doing everything I can.
I know you are, but... But if Sir Harry could only hear the astonishing things he said, it would mean so much.
The man is delirious. You don't actually believe he saw a white gorilla, do you?
Oh, yes, I do.
The fever.
No, Doc. There must be some truth behind the stories those hunters brought back from the interior.
About a white gorilla attacking a native?
Yes, sir.
Poppycock. Some drunken trader probably saw it coming out of a bottle of bourbon.
That's what I thought, until Kunderson showed up. Wait till Sir Harry arrives and I let you in on an amazing discovery. Come in.
Boss! Boat's gone.
That must be Sir Harry. Keep a close watch on our patient.
Righto, but you better hurry. We haven't much time.
Thank you, Peter. It's so nice to see you again.
Thank you. Greetings to you, Sir Harry, who is famous.
The same to you, Fennel, sir.
My sexy, Mr. Carville. Carville, this is Peter Van Dorn, one of my oldest and dearest friends.
How do you do?
Oh, the belly blasted sparrow blew up the blinking spout. Then the belly blasted rain came down and drove the blight around.
Back.
Peter, old boy, glad to see you.
I haven't time to explain, but there's a man dying at my home who holds the key to the most amazing anthropological discovery of the century. Would you mind coming along right away?
Let's go. Best to attend to the unloading.
Immediately, sir.
Come, Pam. Carbo.
Man who saved Gunderson from death at the hands of the Negritos was the doctor who had accompanied Dr. Friedrich Dierdorf's ill-fated expedition.
Dr. Dierdorf? What an amazing story. But the white gorilla, what basis do you have for calling him the missing link?
I was coming. This box contains Dr. Friedrich Dierdorf's personal diary, given to Gunderson by his rescuer. Here, my friends, is the unmistakable proof of the existence of the missing link. A strange beast of seeming characteristics, but with the faculty of almost human cerebration.
You mean a gorilla with human intelligence?
A low grade of intelligence. Dr. Friedrich Dierdorf proved it by applying the standard mentality test.
My word, the old chap must have been a bit cracked to be asking a monkey his size, IBCs.
Cracked or not, Dierdorf's experiments might very well prove the Darwinian theory. I would certainly enjoy the acclaim which will go to the man who takes the missing link back to civilization.
Oh, Father.
I've been hoping you'd say that, Sir Harry.
By Jove, it's worth having a go at it.
Good. We'll be passing through gorilla territory anyhow.
If you ask me, the whole thing's a hoax, just monkey business.
Well, nobody's going to ask you, Carbo. Gunderson is dead. It now becomes our obligation to follow through where he left off.
I can't see what good can come from finding a white monkey. Besides, the jungle's no place for a girl like you.
Meaning you're beginning to regret that you ever left London, eh, what?
Oh, it isn't that. It's just that I can't help thinking of all the needless dangers you have to encounter.
Oh, I love excitement, Clive. You seem to have forgotten that I was born on a safari. However, if you'd rather return to London, I'm sure Father will understand.
Come, Pam, you know being with you makes up for all the discomfort.
All right, come on, get that over there. Come on, let's get moving here.
Good morning, Hans.
Good morning, Herr Van Dorn.
Hans, I want you to meet the leader of our expedition, Sir Harry Pratt.
I am honored by him coming down.
Well, thank you. I'm pleased that Van Dorn was able to engage a man with your qualifications to guide us. My daughter, Miss Pamela.
How do you do?
Pleasure is mine, Fräulein.
My secretary, Carbo.
How do you do, thank you.
and Baxter.
Hello.
Now, Hans, if you'll point out our canoes, we have store our luggage aboard.
What's in the print of here?
What's in the door? Come with me.
Here's the bossman.
Number one bossman. Savvy?
Savvy. Me number one porter boy.
You show bossman the canoe, don't you?
Follow number one porter boy.
You will follow me, I will show you to your canoe.
Shave to make a gentleman.
Righto. But I'm afraid your definition of a gentleman and mine are quite different.
Thank you.
in through the jungle, we come to a trail over the mountains that'll save us over 150 miles of water transport.
By Jove, that'll save a lot of time, too. Nice going, Hans.
You've been over that trail before, Hans?
Yes, sir. Now, about here, we come to a point...
Shove off, my dear. Are all your things still aboard?
Well, yes, Father, but...
But what?
Well, I was wondering if I could have Bishop for my personal guard instead of Springer.
Very well. You shall have Bishop. Take care of it, Hans. I hope Springer hasn't been discourteous to you.
Oh, not at all, mate. Well, I've been observing the way Bishop does things, and, well, I think he's most suitable.
I quite agree with you, my dear.
You've been promoted, Bishop. From rear guard to personal guard for Fräulein Bragdon.
On whose orders?
By the Fräulein. You're a fast worker, my friend.
You're crazy. I haven't spoken two words to the girl. Besides, I like my present duty.
Don't be a dumb girl. If you play your cards right, you've got a chance to marry a fortune.
I'm satisfied.
Anything you say, but you're her guard, so get aboard a canoe.
An ardent admirer.
Mr. Carswell doesn't interest me. That's what you mean.
I don't think you're capable of being interested in anything but yourself.
You're very rude.
And very uncouth. Also a congenital liar. Besides, I'm a positive bounder where women are concerned. Most women.
Thank you.
Who were just passing through to hunt the white gorilla. He said the white gorilla had killed one of his warriors.
Ask him about the old white man who gave the diary to Gunther.
I'm afraid that wouldn't be wise, mein Herr. It might make them more suspicious of us than they are. So what do you propose? I'll ask the chief if he'll allow us to camp here for a few days to rest and do some trading. And if the old white man is still here, he'll seek us.
Quite right, Han. We bow to your better judgment.
Guadalajara, for a combo, Zara Plage, la Potumba. Chief says we can stay here long enough to do some trading, but we can't camp in the village.
Unsociable old devil, isn't he?
Well, I can't say I blame the old boy. He's probably had good reason for it. Have the porters break out some of the cotton goods and trinkets.
Yes, sir. Mumbo Jumbo, coming me. For a cooler, the latage, the latumbaga. Coming to New York. Bragdon, Royal Society of Explorers. And this is Peter Van Dorn, my good friend and noted anthropologist.
Why, this is indeed a pleasure, for I'm quite familiar with your contributions to science. Perhaps you are familiar with the works of my former colleague, Dr. Friedrich Theodorf.
Why, Dr. Theodorf was responsible for our coming here. Or perhaps I should say his diary.
Why, then Gunderson got back alive.
Yes. But he died of jungle fever a few days after he reached Mojave.
You said the diary has brought you here. Is it your intention to search for the missing link?
Yes, and we need your help.
Come with me. Sorry, I have no chairs to offer you. If you don't mind the floor, I'll be with you in a moment.
Well, not at all. Quite all right.
My name doesn't matter. I was the anthropologist who accompanied the ill-fated Diadrov expedition. Anyhow, Diadrov was my friend, and I stuck by him after the others had deserted, and I was a witness to his murder by the missing link.
Doctor, we are very anxious to know what you have in this bag.
Oh, yes. I was going to show you some photos I made. I was afraid to entrust them to Gunderson. Now that is Dr. Frederick Diadrov. In my opinion, one of the world's greatest anthropologists. And they are the members of the expedition, with a portion of our permanent camp in guerrilla territory.
Do you suppose there's any part of their camp still standing?
Hardly. After 10 years, it was a constant fight then to keep the jungle out.
These photographs are priceless, Doctor. We'll guard them with our lives.
Well, there are others there showing the missing link reacting to some intelligent tests we made, which you can study at your leisure. But this one shows him full grown at 5 years, just a few weeks before he broke out of his cage and murdered Diadrov.
We are deeply indebted to you, Doctor. Isn't there something we can do for you in return? Perhaps on our return, you'd like to go back to civilization with us.
No, I'd rather not. My life on this earth is growing short, and my mission, if you can call it such, is about finished. Now, this map will guide you to Diadrov's camp, and I'd advise you to rebuild it and use it as base of all future activity. Otherwise, you may traverse the entire length and breadth of the Congo and never catch sight of a single gorilla.
I assume from your suggestion that Dr. Diadrov used some methods to lure the gorillas into his camp.
Yes. His method was quite simple. He discovered that the medium plant was a choice food for the gorilla, and so he planted it all around his camp. You'll find some photos of the medium in those.
Here you are, Mother. If you don't want it for a Komodo, you can use it for bathroom care.
I don't know about that plant, but I'm going to keep the eyes open. Want me to pick you up a handbag?
Oh, no, thanks. If I were you, I wouldn't do any shooting around this village unless it's absolutely necessary.
Whenever you give the word.
Well, the sooner the better.
Just what I was going to recommend, mein Herr. These Negritos are not very friendly. The chief and his witch doctor might be planning to ambush us from the camp of the night.
What would you advise, Hans?
Continuous travel day and night until we're at least 50 miles from the village.
Excellent suggestion, Hans. Where's Miss Pamela?
She and her cars are down by the river.
Get everything ready to leave immediately.
Yes, ma'am.
Necessary to shove off at once.
can snatch about 40 winks. I'll gladly keep watch.
I'm not tired. I'm used to long watches.
If you change your mind, be gone.
Thanks.
Follow them.
What do you think, Hans?
Why not clear out a space and set up a temporary camp? And if you wish to do some exploring, you'll have a base to operate from. You are right again, Hal. My enthusiasm ran away with me.
I'm glad somebody still has enthusiasm. I'm afraid I lost mine crossing that swamp. Very well, Hans. Let's camp here. After good rest will give my morale a lift.
Mohakana Dunga!
My, so far this film has become so action-packed, don't you think? Indeed. Here at the museum, we have all sorts of attractions, and for tonight's film, for the preservation of gorillas and the advancement of those people who wear the suits of gorillas, pretending to be in movies of ages past, we have brought out our gorilla outfit, or Congo here. He's been here for many, many years. Isn't that right, Boris? Exactly. He's needing a little bit of pruning, a little bit of attire assessments here, you know, picking some of the bugs out. Boris enjoys doing that from time to time, right? Exactly. Oh my goodness. Well, I hope you're enjoying the movie so far, and I hope you've enjoyed seeing some of the exhibits and artifacts here at Gargoyle Manor, the Monster Museum, located in the foothills of Virginia. Go to our website, www.monstermovienight.com. Take a little look at some of the sections. I think it's called Our World. You might be surprised what you might find and see. And of course, if you want to see the real thing, come on by, give us a call, make an appointment. We'll be glad to fit you in, won't we, Boris? We're always looking out for new blood. Let's go back to White Pongo.
What is it? Okay. Good going, Bishop. This must be the spot.
The blighters.
Now all we've got to do is plant medium all around the place and onto the cover.
Yes, and pray for the white gorilla to get hungry, eh?
If it works for Dr. Theodorf, it'll work for us, in spite of your skepticism.
I was only joking.
How do we know if the trap is sprung if we're inside the stockade?
By means of a slight improvement by Baxter over the Theodorf model. Now you see that there bell up there? Now just by way of a demonstration, if you'll all step aside, we'll show you how it goes. First, we hook this in here. Now, Miss Tanner, here's your gorilla. Comes along and gets a whiff of the men job. So he ups to the windfall to whet his appetite. And being a greedy blighter, he eats his way right up to the trap. Well, there's a whole bunch of it out in the center. So, he steps right out there to see what he can do about it. Well, you see how it works, Miss Pamela?
Looks like the Baxter invention is a blooming success.
Looks a bit like a good invention.
That's what I get for making a blasted monkey, me sir.
Party gets back.
Take your time, take your time. They won't be back for hours yet.
All right.
Beautiful night.
What do you say, Webb? Would you like a chance to win back the 20 shillings I took from you last night?
Sure, I'd like to have revenge.
How about you, Bishop?
Some other time. I don't feel lucky tonight.
If you can cock me in hand, I might as well lose my money to you. I've no place to spend it.
Good night, Miss Hamill.
Playing fair with me, Pam.
What do you mean?
Well, ever since we've been in Africa, you've been treating me like a stranger.
Well, I'm afraid it's your fault, Clive. I've rather resented your possessive attitude.
But you know I love you.
And I'm very fond of you. But please don't mistake my friendship for more than it was intended.
Oh, I see.
Let's be good friends. What do you say?
Well, what can I say?
Good night, Clarence.
Good night.
What's the matter?
I just saw a huge beast looking in at me through the window.
There's nothing out there, Pamela.
Oh, but it was there. I saw it. A huge beast with flaming eyes.
Control yourself, my dear. You were probably having a nightmare.
Oh, no, Father. I was wide awake. It was real.
But no jungle beast could get over our stockade wall.
No. Couldn't a gorilla?
Now I know you were dreaming. Gorillas are not climbing beasts.
Sir Harry!
Well, there's nothing wrong. Pamela was dreaming she saw a gorilla looking in her window. And it was so realistic she woke up screaming.
Bishop, you'd better take a look around. Stringer, Webb, check the back fence.
Thank you.
Good evening, Miss Paxton.
I didn't intend to disturb you. Please sit down.
After you, ma'am.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. Why should anyone observe the social life that is here? This isn't civilization. The jungle.
A man shouldn't forget to pay his respects to a charming lady even in the jungle, Miss Paxton.
It is only a reminder that I'm not easy. Stop addressing me as Miss Bragdon. I'm Pamela, and Miss Jeffrey.
What's going on here? Answer me, Bishop. Why did you strike Cargo?
I'm sorry, sir. I must have lost my temper.
Go on, why don't you tell him? Why don't you tell him how I found her in your arms and you were kissing her? I resent such presumption, Bishop. You were engaged as a rifleman, not to make love to my daughter.
I must have lost my head. I'm sorry, sir.
You've lost my confidence and respect. If it were possible, I'd send you back to Mojave.
But, Father, it was all my fault.
I'll talk to you later. Go to your room.
But, Father...
Pamela, in the morning, I shall appoint a more trustworthy guard for my daughter. And if you so much as speak to her again, I'll have you put under arrest. Understand?
Yes, sir.
By Jove, we've captured her!
Well... The quarter could be all right, but not your white man.
I'm satisfied the trap works. That gives me hope.
What are you going to do with it? Shoot it?
Don't be an idiot. If we kill him, all our efforts will be wasted. We'll never have another gorilla come near the place. Baxter, put the ladder down for him.
Right, sir.
We'll give him a chance to get out.
Talk to you, Hans.
What's on your mind?
Well, I'm fed up with this. I'm sick of wasting my time trying to find a white monkey.
So?
You told me that you had a definite purpose in joining this expedition.
Supposing I have?
Well, I'd like to throw in with you if there's a chance.
Without knowing my objective?
Well, anything would be better than this.
If you throw in with us, there can be no backing out, understand? And if we fail... You'll risk being hanged for the rest of us. Well?
I'll do anything if I can take Pamela with me.
Oh, I don't know about that. I hadn't figured on taking a woman along. Suppose she objects to going with you?
Well, suppose the Harry objects to your plans, that isn't going to stop you, is it?
You can take her, but she'll be your responsibility.
All right.
Good, I can tell you our plans now. I know where there's a fabulous gold field... And by borrowing Herr Bragdon's safari, we can bring out enough of the shiny metal to make us richer than the Bank of England.
I'm with you all the way.
Come with me.
This is an outrage. I shall spend every penny I possess to prosecute you, criminals.
Out north will not be then, Sir Harry. It's best to bargain with the blighters.
Carswell, I would never have thought you'd be an accessory to this criminal venture. You must be mad.
Shut up. Tie them up. Mumbo jumbo. Maraco zunga. Maraganga. Get over here.
on you at all.
My friends, we are taking all the guns and supplies with us. But if you make no attempt to follow, we will leave a cache on the riverbank a two-day trek from here. With care, it will be sufficient to get you back to Mojave. But if you attempt to follow, we will leave nothing.
Come on, Pam, you're coming with us.
Oh, no, I'm not.
How dare you, you insolent young bounder. Don't be a fool, Carswell.
Your horse going to get your blooming neck scratched.
You coming, Pam?
No, I'm not.
All right, mumbo-jumbo. Bring the Fräulein with us.
What man said, come you?
Don't you dare touch me.
Raka has the gona.
Take up what you make of the
silver. Mahalagona, gona. Mahala gona.
What is this, Bill?
Bishop, old boy. Now, if we only had some guns, we could take after the blinders and turn the tables on them. If we only had some cartridges.
Perhaps we'll soon have both.
Sure, Kruger is going to leave them for us on the riverbank.
You didn't really believe that, did you?
Didn't you? My dear fellows, Kruger can't possibly afford for us to get out of here alive.
Do you really mean he is cold-blooded enough to leave us stranded without food or guns?
It wouldn't be the first time, Van Doren.
You seem to know quite a bit about Herr Kruger.
It's part of my job. I'm afraid I'm not quite what I seem. You see, I joined your safari under orders from the Rhodesian Secret Service. About 18 months ago, the bodies of a party of prospectors were found in the bush, each man shot through the head. We discovered they had hired a guide. The guide's body wasn't there. I can only tell you, gentlemen, that the description of the guide fits Kruger very well. Further, it was established there were two other members of the original party, riflemen, hired by the same guide. Their bodies weren't there either. Webb and Stringer. Very positive.
Yes, but what are we going to do for guns and supplies?
I've taken care of that.
Bishop, I owe you an apology.
There isn't time for that now. Every minute that Pamela's with Kruger, she's in danger.
If you'll take command, we'll follow you.
Good enough. Come on.
Become the prey of some wild beast. Mumbo Jumbo, Araka Segura.
The Venezia, the Venezia Renault.
Thank you.
Watch out!
Here. Make it fast. Let's go.
Come on, hurry up with that canoe back there. Mahana Bana!
All aboard, everybody. All right, boys. Did you hear me? I said all aboard.
But you promised me food and guns on the bank for Father and the others.
I've changed my mind, Fräulein.
But you've got to. If you don't, they'll starve to death.
It's either their lives or mine, Fräulein, and I believe in self-preservation.
Clive, you can't let him do this. It's the same as murder.
She's right. It would be murder. You've got to give them a fighting chance.
Shut up! I want any advice from you, I'll ask for it. I'll get aboard, both of you. Pam!
British spunk in you. But when I give orders, you've got to learn to obey them. Now get up, Fräulein. I have no more time to waste.
Then all of a sudden we heard the savage roar of a jungle beast, and Krogat cried for help, and Miss Bragdon screaming. We finally found him. Krogat had been killed by a huge gorilla who was holding Miss Bragdon in his arms. And he was a white gorilla. Thank you.
You look like some lion found Corbett's body during the night.
Yes.
Gorilla tracks. From now on, we'll have to be careful not to overlook any signs. We'll probably find lots of those tracks, but the deeper ones we'll have to follow. The white gorilla was carrying over 100 pounds of extra weight. Come on.
Thank you.
certainly hope his disposition improves. He doesn't seem at all pleased with the fame that's coming his way.
Ready to go, bye-bye.
And we've gathered enough men to feed him for a year.
Well, I can hardly wait until we get back to London. I know a couple of anthropologists who will get the surprise of their lives when we exhibit him. You really think he's a missing link between man and monkey?
I am convinced that he is. In the few tests we've been able to make, he has shown a much higher intelligence quotient than any other ape we've ever heard of.
Well, whether he is or not, he's going to be the subject of controversy for the next 50 years. And his appearance will startle the world.
Oh, pardon me, Bishop. Do you think the white gorilla will...
I see that you survived the film. I hope you enjoyed it. Wasn't it wonderful? That poor, poor gorilla. You know, a few years past, when I was just a lad, there actually was a rare albino white gorilla. His name was Snowflake. It was the sweetest little gorilla ever to be seen. I'm not sure what happened to that poor thing, but there was actually two, maybe three, that was ever born and maybe raised in captivity. I'm not sure the story, but there really was a white pongo of sorts. Again, we hope that we've helped rouse some awareness for the gorilla trade. And of course, we send out heartfelt sorrow for the gorilla that lost its life. And of course, we were glad that the child was saved. But you know how it goes. The monster usually loses, the human usually wins. But not always. Not here at Monster Movie Night. Until next time, keep screaming.